Hi students, since most of you are asking about the solution video of the mock test paper, so I am giving you a video on the solution of the mock test paper explaining the things that have appeared here, and I think after watching this video you will get your queries resolved. Now first of all, we will write the net profit here on the PL application account credit side. Net profit is 5,10,000. Next is interest on drawings 1080 and 1350 for A and P respectively. Now how we got this interest on drawings, let us check this. Interest on drawings is for A 3000 at the mid of every month. What I was given in the question was 3000 at the mid of every month. So 3000 at the mid of every month, there are 12 months in a year. So first of all, we'll multiply it with 12. So 3000 into 12. Next is the rate of interest on drawings was 6% per annum. So it is 6/100. So we have taken 6% here, and since it was mid of every month, so the mid is 6/12. I have provided one table for this at the very beginning when we have started our classes, that whenever we need to calculate the interest on drawings, we have to check whether it is beginning of the month, mid of the month, end of the month, similarly beginning of quarter, end of quarter, mid of quarter. So mid of the month is 6/12, beginning of month is 6.5/12, end of the month is 5.5/12. You will get that table in some of my videos or in the previous pictures that is available on this group. Now mid of the month is 6/12, so 3000 into 12 into 6/100 into 6/12 will give us 1080 for A. Let us check for P has withdrawn 9000 at the beginning of each quarter. So there are four quarters in a year. Quarter is a period of 3 months, so we have four quarters in a year. So 9000 withdrawn in each quarter means he has withdrawn 9000 for 4 times in a year. 9000 into 4, since there are 12 months we multiply it with 12, and since there are 4 quarters in a year, so we will multiply with 4. So 9000 into 4 into 6% is the rate 6/100, and 7.5 is the rate for the beginning of quarter. Beginning of quarter is 7.5, mid of quarter is 6, and the end of quarter is 4.5. so we will use 7.5/12. That will provide us 1350 for P. So this was the interest on drawings for A and P respectively, 1080 and 1350, that we have written on the PL appropriations account credit side. On the debit side, interest on capital, more or less everybody has calculated correctly. Salary 1000 per month, so 12 into 1000 will give us 12000. Transfer to general reserve, this will calculate, it was given in the question, 6% of the divisible profits. So first of all, we'll find the divisible profit. This is not the divisible profit that we'll use for the general reserve. We'll not be using this divisible profit for the general reserve. We'll be using the divisible profit that is appearing before we have made the actual divisible profit. So here we have 5,10,000 and 2430. That provides us 5,12,430. The same total, we'll copy this side. From this total, we'll deduct the amount of the interest on capital and the salary. 81,000 and 12,000 we'll deduct. What I've done here, first of all, we'll calculate DP for the transfer to general reserve. That is net profit plus interest on drawings, 5,10,000 plus 2430 minus interest on capital minus salary. So we got 4,19,430. So this is the divisible profit. This divisible profit, we'll calculate 6% of this divisible profit to get the transfer for general reserve. So 6% of this divisible profit will give us 25,166. So this is the transfer to general reserve that we have written here. Transfer to general reserve 25,166. Now after we write this 25,166, now we need to calculate the actual DP. Now we'll do the same process what we do. 512,430. From this we'll subtract 81,000, 12,000 and 25,166. After we subtract this 25,166 also, we'll get this figure, 394,264, that you can see here. After we deduct 25,166 from the earlier DP, we'll get 394,264. From this, the division of profit was to be made, first 90,000 in the ratio of PSR, that is 2:1, and the rest amount equally. So from this 394,264, first of all, we'll subtract 90,000. That allows us, that provides us 304,264. This 90,000 is divided in the ratio of 2:1. 2:1, when we divide 90,000 in 2:1, 2/3 and 1/3, we'll get 60 and 30 for A and P respectively. So 90,000 is divided in 2:1. Here we got 60,000 and 30,000. 2/3 of 90,000 and 1/3 of 90,000. And the remaining amount, total profit, total diesel profit was 394,264. From here we have already subtracted 90,000 that will distribute in the PSR. The rest of the amount is left 3,04,264. This will be divided equally. This amount is divided in two equal halves. So when we divide this item by two, you will get a figure that is 1,52,132. 1,52,132. This is to be said by both the partners. So 1,52,132 for A and 152,132 for B also. Similarly, 60 plus this much will give this much for A, and 30 plus this much will give this much for B. That we have done here also. The same thing I have shown here. You could also have done in the working note, and you could just write the amount here. That will also do, but you will need to write the working note number. This is working note 2, calculation of DP. You just write here the working note number and you can write this amount directly. You don't need to show this calculation here. Now, in this manner we have completed our PL appropriation account. After we have completed our PL appropriation account, partner's capital account is quite easy, and I think it is very easy to understand. Drawings, some students have made a mistake here in writing the drawings. That will be 36,000 for both. 3,000 per month for A, so 12 months into 3,000, 36,000, and 9,000 per quarter for P. 9,000 per quarter provides us 9,000 into, there are 4 quarters, so 9,000 into 4, 36,000, and the interest on drawings that we have calculated, 1,080 and 1,350. In this manner, you will get this balance CD here. Now, I hope you have understood the question quite correctly. And still, if you have any queries, you can for sure text me or call me at any time. Thank you very much and bye. Also, prepare for your unit test quite well.